the external microphone hooked up to this little headset here, since that's all I have for an external microphone. Anyway, I'm gonna put this up right here so that we can hear that clearly. Now, let's see. Now, where did I put my magnets? Ah, here it is. Right now, it seems like it's at a little stalemate. This pin connected to ground. Well, actually, I have this pin here connected to a transistor, which is connected to ground. That's cool. Ambulance, let's do it again. So I'm planning to circuit bend this whole setup here, but with a different radio. Same exact model, but has a little more defects. How about turn this thing upside down? have shifted to FM. Oh yeah, that's right. FM uses this thing right here. That's why. Now I'm gonna go for my original plan. Well, actually, let me just do a couple more things first. Sound effect, there you go. We now have it. Alright, I'm gonna connect this thing to ground. Anyway, I have to connect this to pin 11. And look what happens when I change the time. Thank you. channel was it? I think it was like 104 or something. It was at 96 originally. We are way off. Originally over here. I believe we were originally over here. You see that? You notice anything? Let me turn on the volume. Seems like volume does play a part in this. Ground. That doesn't seem to do anything. Alright, just gotta keep it like that. See when I see that how it changes 7? When I change to 7, it changes frequency. That's a potential area to focus on when circuit bending this. Thank you. That's pretty cool. Overall, I think that is a pretty successful circuit bending test. Thank you for watching. I know it's been a while since we ever done one of these, and it's our first time ever circuit bending something functioning like this. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Anyway, I'll catch you in the next one. I'm going to potentially make this a permanent thing. Again, with the other radio of the same model. So take care, guys.